Morning.
Hi, Jim.
This person.
Oh, he's right there. Okay. The glasses. Okay. Just want to make sure there's somebody up here with me.
I can always help you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Making sure I didn't interrupt any music. Good morning.
Good morning.
We worship this morning. We're glad that you're with us this first Sunday of Advent. It seems unbelievable, isn't it, that we are in that new season of church. There are a number of announcements in your bulletin that you can get up on the screen. I'll just highlight a couple of those. A reminder that there's another worship opportunity this week. On Wednesday is our monthly Tithe Day service in the chapel. If you haven't experienced that, I invite you to give that a try. It's a wonderful, another very different kind of worship experience that we do here at church. You'll see in the announcements that we are a church that collects things. We collect, there's mittens and hats, we're collecting socks and lots of stuff down in the library and the cabinets where we are collecting all kinds of things for people that are in need around our community. So I encourage you to look at all those things that we're collecting, and if you can bring something to contribute to those, that would be great. Just want to say a word of thanks to all of these wonderful musicians, some have come here just to be here with us today and help us with our worship service. These folks in green have been here, I know, numerous special rehearsals just to get ready for this morning. So we're really thankful for all the work that everybody's done and Claire for pulling this all together this morning. We will be, this is our one table service. We will be celebrating communion this morning. We've done that a number of different ways. This morning we'll be going up to the dining room and serving right now. Just stay right here for communion, and you're going to stay in your pews this morning. So communion will be served in the pews, and I just want to remind you that we've done this a couple of different ways, and I invite you to partake of the elements as they're served to you. You don't have to go. All right, anything else I'm forgetting that else was? All right, then let's take a moment to remind ourselves as we begin worship that we are not strangers as we begin. We are brothers and sisters in Christ. Let's stand and greet one another with the peace of Christ.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Deep within them to create something new. One of these inmates writes,
writes this.
I am hopeful, he wrote, that people forgive and give chances to those against whom they hold grudges. And I hope that the world can be a better place for us all. I am hopeful that everyone can see each other's unique ways and learn from one another, because the fruits of that thought will sprout and blossom.
Let us pray. Holy God, fill us with the hope that things can change for us and the world. Guide and direct us during this time of anticipation and preparation. Amen.
Thank you. carry us out of the darkness. As it was for Israel, so it is for us. The hope kindled by the coming of the Messiah is the flame that melts our hearts and binds us to one another. Isaiah foretold that the Savior would come not as a conquering king or a great warrior, but as a child. His name would be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Thank you. arrival. And at Advent, we're waiting for the arrival of the baby Jesus.
Ah, does that mean I gotta order more pizza?
Well, I don't think so. I wouldn't worry about the pizza. But you're right. Advent is a time when we prepare for the arrival of Jesus. That's why the choir is singing about Jesus today. They're helping us prepare our hearts and our minds for the coming of Jesus into our lives.
What kind of preparing do you gotta do?
Well, during Advent, we ask ourselves if we've been paying attention to the life and ministry of Jesus. And we look at our own lives to see if we're doing the work of Jesus today in everything that we do.
See, me, Jesus is coming to kind of do an inspection.
No, not really an inspection. The fact that God came to live among us in the person of Jesus means that God cares about everything we do and knows how hard it is for us to live a life of love and compassion and hope.
I hope I'm getting more pizza for Christmas.
Well, I hope so too.
I gotta go.
Well, I hope all of you are doing something to help prepare for the coming of Jesus. Let's say a prayer. Let's put our hands together and let's say a prayer. Dear God, we thank you for the baby Jesus who came to us on Christmas and for the way that he helps us to live our lives with love and compassion and hope. Amen. Good job, everybody.